It's 9:37. Thanks so much for being with us on Live at 9. And the years that matter most, for many, that may mean their college or university years.
Yeah, but as well, many of all these people know that college isn't, well, we know, it isn't for everyone.
That's right.
But now one author is taking on higher education and how it can make or break us. Paul Tuff is here with what he's learned through some of his research. Thank you for joining us
this
morning.
Good to have you.
Well, thank you. Great to be here.
First of all, what made you tackle this topic?
Well, I've been writing about education for more than a decade.
Right. You are a noted journalist. And in fact, we'll link to your website.
Thank you. But a lot of what I found in my reporting, both looking at the data and talking to individual students, was that these years after high school have become so important in young people's success. We've also put just so much stress, I think, on young people. The question of where to go to college, whether to go to college, now has all this weight on it, and that puts a lot of pressure on 17 and 18 and 19 year olds.
Absolutely, because as those of us who have been there know, we don't always know what we really are interested in or adept at that age. So did you examine the gap year idea in this, and what did your research show?
Well, in theory, a gap year can be a great thing, and in reality as well. The problem, I think, for a lot of young people is that if they take a couple of years and don't have a real sense of purpose or direction, aren't learning something outside of college, those years can just be wasted.
They can begin to drift.
Exactly. And so then you've spent 4 or 5 years doing minimum wage jobs, and now you know what you want to do, you feel the pressure, but it's harder to get going. It still works, it's still possible at that point, and often young people are more motivated at that point to really focus. But we need to do a better job of providing good pathways and advice to young people as soon as they finish high school.
Yeah, that makes sense.
In this research, has there been anything that has surprised you? You know, in some of this?
Lots of things. So I think the big surprise for me was how much we all as a nation have been taking money away from public higher education over the past couple of decades. This is a moment when other countries are all investing in public universities, where all the signs in the job market are that we need more graduates. But we are now putting all the pressure and all the expense on young people, on families. So that means more tuition costs, more debt, and more pressure on those students.
Wow, that's an interesting observation. So by what you're saying, it sounds like, is that now public education has become so expensive that it adds to the layer of pressure, and perhaps that leads to the wrong decision on where to go, that sort of thing. There's been a lot in the last few years of talk that shows, or research that shows, it really doesn't matter where you get your undergrad for most fields of study. Did that bear out in your research?
For some students. It's actually more true for affluent students. So well-off students, where you go matters less. For low-income students, it really can matter. And I talked to a lot of low-income working-class students for whom the decision was really crucial.
I'm going to ask you, though, is that because it's who you know in our society? It's not so much the quality of the education.
I think that's possible. I think one of the things that economists have a hard time doing is sort of disentangling what you get out of a college degree. So knowledge has something to do with it, connections has something to do with it, but also just the process of going through those 2 years or 4 years of meeting deadlines and learning those skills, that matters a lot as well. In a way, it kind of doesn't matter what it is that you're getting out of college. It's clear that when people get a degree, they are more employable, more likely to make decent salaries.
Well, it demonstrates a determination and a willing to stick to a plan and set a goal and that sort of thing, which
matters.
Is valuable in any field of study.
Absolutely. Statistically, how are you breaking these things down? I know you mentioned income, but anything else? How are you breaking these down?
To look at the value of college, you mean?
Yeah, mostly by income. I mean, the other key data point is whether a student is first generation or not, meaning did their parents go to college.
I was a first generation,
Got it. And so, well, you know, for first generation students, there's more pressure. It's often more difficult. Your parents don't have that kind of college history that they can draw on. But it's also more valuable when a first generation student is able to complete a degree. It makes a huge difference in your future.
So who is this most for? The parents of a student looking at college or the student? Is it written in a way that the student can get the benefit? In other words,
I hope a little of both. I mean, certainly it's parents, I think, who are feeling the pressure at this point. But the book is also really for all of us. I mean, in a way, I feel like this problem is something that is not just up to families and kids to solve. We need to rethink the way we have organized our higher education system, and that falls on all of us.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. You have a book signing tonight, 6 p.m. at Novel. You're going to love this bookstore.
Good.
So please come out, get your copy, and meet Paul.
Thank you.